Jackrabbit Soccer Weekly Update on the precipice of the Summit League Championships. And Maya Hansen alongside with us, the savage Minnesota native. How many years is this for you in yellow and blue?
My fourth year.
But it's not the last.
Nope, it's not the last.
You're coming back for one more. Well, the career numbers are very impressive. Total number of points scored, 96. Total number of goals scored, 39. I bring that up not to force an awkward smile out of you, although I know it does, but there's a lot to this, and we speak of this a lot, but I know you will back this up. That's an individual honor, but it's not an individual accomplishment. There's so many other wrinkles and so many teammates that have played a role in you scoring all of those points.
Yeah, everyone this year, everyone in my past 3 years has individually like made an impact and made a difference. So that's definitely a team accolade, and you can't achieve something like that without teammates and coaches that support you, and everyone's just each other's biggest cheerleader and wants to see each other succeed. So everyone has played a part in that.
Well, to hold school records, what does that mean?
It's exciting. Everyone keeps saying to take it in and really enjoy this moment. So that's what I'm trying to do. But it's definitely a team accolade.
Okay, speaking of the team, this has been a great year for Jackrabbit Soccer to date. What makes this team special?
We have so many connections off the field, and I think that really translates to our chemistry on the field. We've just kind of had this trust and love for each other. And so, we can't play good soccer without having those connections.
You are two wins away from returning to the College Cup, but we know that's two very challenging victories. They're always harder in the postseason. So being this close, what will it take for this team to achieve its goal?
We've been doing great all season long. We just need to keep doing what we know how to do. I think something that's important for us is just going out and playing loved and having fun and just remembering why we play soccer and why we love it. And if we just stick to kind of our roots like that, then we usually play some of our best soccer.
How much of an advantage is it having Sunday's game here in Brookings at Fishback Soccer Park?
As you saw in North Dakota, probably our fans travel pretty well, but it's really fun to play at Fishback. So we're super excited to be back at home and just have one more opportunity to play here.
Now we talk with head coach Brock Thompson leading up to the Summit League Championships. I want to talk about Maya a little bit and reiterate the all-time leader in Jackrabbit history, 39 goals, 96 points. We've discussed her off and on throughout the years here, but she is a special young lady that wears yellow and blue.
100%, and you know, super proud of Maya. She works really hard at her craft, and has put in some very big performances for us over the years. But more importantly, she's a great leader. She's our team captain. She's an incredible teammate, and I think Jackrabbit Soccer is really, it's made up of special people, and Maya's one of those. And Maya would be just as quick to tell you that part of her strength is the team. And so it's a really cool time for us, and it was cool to celebrate that on Sunday.
To finish out the regular season unbeaten, you had to go on the road and beat two North Dakota schools, two teams that were playing for a lot. So you knew you were going to get their best shot. They knew how important Friday and Sunday was respectively for North Dakota and then North Dakota State. So to come away with two wins on the road, what impressed you about your squad?
Just the consistency and the different types of games. You know, obviously we played, both of the games were a little bit different. UND tried to shorten the game, made it very hard for us to score. We've played in some of those games on a little bit of a smaller field on grass. And then all of a sudden on Sunday, we're playing a team that, you know, was in the tournament based on their result Friday night. So they kind of went for it. It was a little bit more wide open. It was on turf. A little bit more combative, and so two very different games, and just really proud that our team was able to play with the consistency that we're capable of in difficult environments and difficult situations.
A lot of standouts, but one of them was Rachel Preston, who was honored by the Summit League as the peak performer on defense for her efforts in both Fargo and Grand Forks.
Yeah, I thought Rachel really, from the second half of UND through the NDSU game, was fantastic and stepped up and buried a penalty kick for us to give us a two-goal margin against UND. And then I thought the NDSU game may have been one of her better ones over the course of the season. And Rachel's played a lot of big games for us and provides a lot of leadership for us across the back line. And Sunday was great. NDSU has some very dynamic attacking players. And it takes some experienced players to deal with that, and Rachel was well-deserving of that award.
Let me ask you a wide-open question here. What has been the key, or why, I should say, have you been so successful this year as a team?
To be honest with you, it's 100% that we have focused on just delivering our best each and every moment. And you know, this is the time of the year where people talk a lot about accolades and streaks and records and in the future. And that's maybe the biggest challenge that we face. I'm so impressed and proud of how our team shows up every day and just decides, hey, let's get better today. Let's deliver our best and be okay with whatever that produces. You know, whether that's win, loss, or tie on the scoreboard. If we deliver our best, there's no regrets. We play with a great amount of love for each other. And you stack those performances on top of each other over the course of a season. And then you can look back on it and say, wow, you know, that we did some pretty remarkable things. But that's really the key, is to stay present and to really, for us, not to focus on the outcome, but to focus on the performance and the connection we have with each other.
All right, let's talk about the Summit League Championship and this new format now. It's a two-week scenario. It used to be four teams went to one site. You played a Thursday, Saturday with a championship on Saturday. Now the top two seeds each host kind of a mini bracket to get to the championship. You being the two seed, you get to host. So 3 and 6 will play each other on Friday night. Then you get the winner on Sunday afternoon. Just to begin things, let's talk about the change in format and adding two more teams to the Summit League postseason.
Yeah, I think it's a great change, and really, you know, really proud of the Summit League for making that move. You know, I think the past few years we were the lowest percentage in all Division I conferences of the number of teams that were participating in the postseason women's soccer tournament, and here's the reality of it. NDSU and UND they're deserving of playing in the conference championship with the years that they've had, and in previous years they wouldn't be in it. From that, and that's the bottom line. And in previous years, we've had teams that have put together seasons that have deserved, their student athletes have deserved to play in the postseason, and now they have a chance. It also gives a little bit of a benefit, whether that's hosting or the bye, to teams that finish 1 and 2. And I think that's an important piece too. Is regular season games mean a lot in the Summit League when you play 9 of them to figure out, you know, where you're going to sit and what the standings are going to be like. And so I think it's a really great change. I think there's some challenges to it from a format standpoint and to be ironed out. But kudos to the Summit League for really, I think, standing up for a student-athlete experience.
All right, for your team, being the 2 seed, like you talked about, you don't have a game on Friday, so you get to watch the 3 and the 6, Omaha and North Dakota play, and then you'll get the winner of them on Sunday. So what's kind of the week look like, and how do you handle this, knowing that you have that bye and you don't play until the semis on Sunday?
Yeah, you know, we're taking an extra day off. So today is not today is probably our heaviest work day in a traditional week. We're building in a little bit more rest and able to spread out some of the things, whether it's video or regeneration stuff, over at the beginning of the week. We can spread it out to manage our players a little bit better. But once tomorrow comes, it'll be pretty much a normal prep into a game. You know, we've played Saturday only games. That's kind of what the week will look like.
All right, you get to do this at home. You get to play in the semifinals at Fishback Soccer Park. We talked about it with Maya as well. That is an advantage for your team.
Yeah, we've been very good at home, and our fans have been fantastic. The community's been fantastic, and we're just grateful. We're grateful for the connection that our players and Jackrabbit Soccer has with the community of Brookings and the soccer community in South Dakota, and excited to bring playoff soccer right here to Brookings.
All right, if you are to survive this weekend and move on to the championship next weekend, what will it take from your team?
To just be us, and I think any time that you're in the postseason, sometimes there's a little bit of temptation to try to do more than what you've needed to do all season long, and that can get your team disjointed a little bit. And so it's to stay true to us, to stay true to the principles that make Jackrabbit Soccer what it is, and those are simple things that are done consistently. And if we continue to do the simple things consistently, we can play at a really, really high level. If we try to do too much because of a sense of we need to win this game with this one play, our team can kind of be a little bit more disjointed. And so staying true to ourselves and kind of what we're all about.